Hello everybody and welcome to a mount farming guide for World of Warcraft in 6.2. So are you looking to farm raid logout mounts such as Deathwing or just the old good Lich King? This is the video for you, definitely. So the first thing I want to talk a little about is add-ons. I suggest that you get the add-on that is called Saved Instance, just because this add-on here gives a really nice overview of the different characters you're going to be using. So in my example, I'm going to be using my main character to show the video on, and then I have all the logouts on a random character that is, you know, as high level as is needed to enter the raid. So in my case, this could actually just be a level 90 character. Yeah, I think it was just level 90 to get the logouts that I need to farm. But for most people, it's just easier, you know, to put all the logouts on a character at level 100. So how to get the logouts in the first place? Well, either you clear the raids or you buy the logouts. I think you can actually buy all logouts and then just enter the raid and get saved. So what you want to do here is that you buy the logout from a guy in the trade channel or whatever. Pay a decent fee, 500 gold or whatever. Then you enter the raid, and as soon as you enter the raid, you're gonna be turning it on to heroic. If you don't want to pay a logout, that is too much trouble for you interacting with other people and whatnot, then you can just clear the raid. But now I need to talk a little about what you actually need to clear to do it correctly. So Dragon's Soul, we're going to be clearing that on normal 25 mode. Not heroic, not 10 man normal. 25 man normal. And the same thing is for Throne, not heroic, not 10 man normal, 25 normal. Icecrown Sizzle, 25 normal, not 10 man normal, not 25 heroic, just 25 man normal mode. And by the way, you can skip Balifier the Dreamwalker if you are not on a healing class, so that's no problem there. Ulder, here I can't quite remember, but you can also buy a logout for this. But I do believe that you can clear Uldur on heroic, you know, clear completely normal on heroic 25 man mode and all that without messing anything up. But for the other logouts that I'm gonna show in the video, you need to be a little more on the ball. Another thing I also need to mention, that if you do buy a logout from a dude, you need to actually clear a boss inside the raid. So say I'm gonna be farming Elegon. I'm just gonna take Elegon as an example now. So I pay 500 gold into the raid and I get the logout. I can't extend the logout to the next week if I don't clear anything in the raid. So as you can see, I have extended the raid out logs that I'm gonna be showing. The problem here is that not every class can say solo Elegon, so you're gonna need help to clear up to Elegon if you're gonna farm specific mounts that are a bit hard to solo, such as Elegon or Horidion or the bird mount from the same raid instance in Throne of Iceland or whatever that raid was called. But okay, for everything out of the way, let's set it up. It's pretty easy, everyone knows about this by now. So you're just gonna go into pre-made custom, start a group, and you can just type, I just like to call it something small, because if I call it something small, less people will notice the raid and there's not gonna be that many sign up. Now comes the annoying part, at least for me. I feel like this is the worst part. I have to relog quite a bit. Now, you could put in an auto accept, but I feel like it's annoying with people entering out and in of the group and all that stuff. So I'm just gonna be relogging, getting the invite, going back to accept the invite, and so forth. So let's feel free to skip ahead if you already kind of get this, but I want to show this in real time how to set this up, because this is a very important thing that a lot of people maybe don't quite know about. So I go in on my the character I'm going to be farming the logouts now, so he's not saved to anything. And then I'm gonna go back to my mage now, who has the logouts, who made the group. Really, really nice if you don't have many add-ons and an SSD for this, because there's gonna be a lot of relogs every week for this. And since I run World of Warcraft with a lot of add-ons, do have an SSD, it does take a while to relog in and out of the game. That's just a little annoying thing there. So as you can see here, now Juntas, with the character I'm going to be farming on, is, you know, in the... So I'm just gonna be inviting him. And now everything is set up. Well, I just need to log back on Juntas, and it's pretty much done. Before I end this little clip here, I need to tell a little thing as well. So now I'm just gonna go back into Juntas to show that that actually did work, and I'm gonna be in the group. And you see, I get the invite. Now, there is a thing here. So as you can see, I need to get the leader. I'm not the group leader or raid leader currently, but after some time that will pass over. So by the time I have flown over to the instance that I'm going to, it should have passed like no problem at all, and everything should be totally fine. But that was the first little clip here. So have a good one and enjoy the rest of the guide. So first up is Throne of the Four Winds, or I like to call it just Alakia, because that is the only raid boss that I'm interested. This method I'm going to be showing now can be utilized for places like Elegon, Horidian, and so forth. So raids like Mr. Pandaria pretty much, and most of Cataclysma I guess this method could be used for as well. So I'm still in the group from before, and before I even got to the raid instance here, I did fly quite fast, I was past the leader automatically. And this is important because you need to make sure that before you enter the raid, you're gonna be having it on normal mode, because I cleared it on normal mode, so the mage here cleared the first boss on normal mode. Oh, now I'm of course getting targeted by some stupid hunter. Okay. So, we're just gonna be entering right now, it's pretty simple. A bit of loading time as always. And as you can see, as soon as I enter, it asks me to be saved. I'm gonna accept this, this is fine, I'm gonna accept that. And then as soon as I have accepted it, I'm just gonna put it on heroic. And now you really need to make sure that it is on heroic. You cannot fail this one, because if you pull the boss while it's on 25 man normal, this will save Juntas, the character that I cleared it on. So that will fuck it up completely. So you need to make sure that it is on heroic mode. That is very important. But as you can see now, I can just instantly jump to Alakir. And skip ahead if you don't want to see the kill, but I wanted to include just a bit of gameplay as well, because it's kind of funny to nuke down these bosses, and then you can also see just how fast it actually is to kill on my main character, my Feral Druid, which has unused trinkets and the legendary ring. Sorry if it's a bit loud, you know, my keyboard and whatnot, but I really like to spam a lot. And yeah, we're already at the last phase. My soul capacitor progged right at the start. That was kind of funny. And I like to kill Alakir just a little bit slower in phase 2 to make sure it doesn't bug out and whatnot. But that is pretty much how you're gonna farm most of the raid bosses. There are certain bosses that can be farmed via this method. And the next one is gonna be Deathwing. So, next one is Deathwing. A little note here, while you're flying there from Conclave and Alakir, you should turn it back to normal mode, if you cleared it obviously on normal mode. Because if you enter it on heroic mode, you're gonna get no saved logout. But if you enter it as normal, this is the screen that's gonna pop up. So I'm gonna accept this, and then I'm gonna do nothing else. Now comes the gray area of the video. I was kind of, I wouldn't really want to show this because it's kind of like an exploit, and if you are not really liking exploits in the game, don't do this method. Honestly, I don't want to clear Dragon Soul anymore because I'm just so bored of it, and I did recently get Ultraction Mount, which means that in order to only farm Deathwing without having to clear it every week up to Deathwing itself, this is the method. So what I'm gonna be doing now is definitely a gray area. You're gonna click, you know, you go to Thrall, inconceivable, he couldn't possibly be alive. Then you're gonna do nothing, don't click, don't accept. Then you're gonna hover over your, you know, your character or whatever. Then you're gonna go into raid difficulty, then you're gonna go into heroic. And then you're gonna be using a little macro that I have in the description below. I will share that macro. But again, this is a gray area, and let's see if it does work when I did show it in the video now. But yeah. Yeah, let's just start off from again. So okay, you talk to him. Don't do anything. Then you're gonna go a raid difficulty, heroic, and then you're just gonna push the macro. Then you get a loading screen. It's the funny thing is that deadly boss modes can't even register that you started it on heroic. It's gonna say you started it as 25 man normal, but obviously you did not do that. And man, the soul capacity in a trinket is so stupid on single target when you just wanna nuke down something fast. You're standing there, what? I only do 2-3% of the damage. Usually it's dead by now, then the proc comes and you do so much damage, it's totally overkill. Yeah, this trinket is really crap. But yeah, as always, I'm gonna have the marker in the description below. It seems to work, you know, maybe Blizzard will fix this, they probably should, but this is the only way that I have found, you know, in order to do this. Obviously, if I still needed the Ultraction Mount, I would clear it as usual. It is still a lot of gold to clear Dragon Soul every week, but when you really only need the mounts from the last boss, it's just so annoying having to clear up to him. So that is why I wanted to begin doing this little gray area macro here. Now the stupid soul capacitator coming again. Oh, this is gonna be like the slowest clear I've done in weeks. Okay, so the last little part, I just nuked down Deathwing. Obviously save cooldowns. Now it's procced again. Let's see if I'm gonna fail now due to the... nah, okay. It's down. But as you can see down here, deadly boss modes again, it doesn't register at all that you just did this on heroic. It still thinks that you're on 25 man normal mode. So even an add-on doesn't understand what the hell is going on. So now I'm going to be showing the loot. Obviously 416th item level is the drops that drops on heroic. So yeah, as you can see here, this is clearly heroic, you know, loot. 416. So yeah, it works perfectly. Anywho, on with the next boss, and this one is definitely the easiest one of them all. Well, it's quite easy to farm, not that complicated. So next up is Lich King. Definitely one of the worst bosses to farm just because of all the roleplay, but it's really easy to farm this one, just like Jogserum, which is gonna come up next. You pretty much can just buy a logout and then clear a boss on heroic or whatever gets saved somehow. Or you can just clear it up as well, that's up to yourself. But the important part here is that you enter it on normal mode, so you make sure that it is on normal mode before you enter the raid. At least I think this is important. You don't need to do this for your Xeron, but I like to do it just in case. So I'm gonna accept it, and as soon as I have accepted it, I'm just gonna hit it on heroic. And now it's gonna say ask me again, and I'm gonna say accept. And then I'm just gonna go up and kill him, pretty much. Maybe I can even avoid being knocked back and fail. Like in before, I do get knocked back and I fail completely in this kill. Nah, it's not gonna go that badly. But yeah, I definitely hate having to do this fight here just because the roleplay and flying out to him. So there is a problem here. I want to do both Lich King and Joxaron, you know, on the same go. But on characters that only have one, you know, teleport to the Laren, so that is the Hearthstone set to Mr. Pandaria, you kind of get a bit of a downtime, or you have to fly, you know, get out of the Icecrown Citadel raid, and then you have to fly all the way from the Icecrown Citadel and all the way out to Storm Peaks. That's quite a bit of a time wasted. But yeah, that's probably the biggest downside of my method, but it's really just nice being able to get all the bosses that I'm showing in the video now done in one go. So you don't have to bother with all these many relocks and whatnot several times. But yeah, let's nuke this guy down. Oh, and now I completely screwed up my start rotation. But yeah, let's see if I can't just get it down before he starts knocking me down. And roleplay time. But yeah, I'm just gonna let it run now and perhaps be a little bit quiet. No reason to really watch this, but I wanted to include every kill just because some people do like you know, gameplay and whatnot, so I wanted to include it of all the bosses. But now we're just gonna have to wait on the roleplay for the next 2 minutes. If you're interested in the marker, I can tell that it basically just switches over to heroic mode and starts the encounter. So it kind of like bugs it out. I don't know quite how I'm going to explain this properly, but it starts the encounter, you know, kind of forces it to be started while it switches to heroic, and that is definitely an exploit in some way. I don't know if this is a really a heinous thing to do, because I mean, come on, it's just for farming a mount and stuff like that. So yeah, but that is pretty much how the Marco works for Deathwing. This is some ultra settings, by the way. Wow, it does look kinda okay, even if it's an old game, I guess. And it's down. The funny thing is that the deadly boss mode counter is way off, at least by 20 seconds or something, usually for me. So that's at least nice enough to know. And let's see what the loot was. Oh my god, no mount. What a big surprise. Nah, I haven't really ever found this guy here for the mount before. I didn't really bother with it until kinda now, so yeah. That was pretty much it for the Deathwing, so let's take Joxaron next. So next one is the easiest one for me at least. This is just Joxaron in older. The good thing is that you can buy a lockout, but the problem is that if you want to extend the lockout, you need to clear something. So my lockout has every boss cleared, including Algolon. So I went and cleared Algolon, which the seller haven't cleared, in order to make sure that the character that I saved the raid ID on can extend the lockout. But yeah, any class, you know, bow level 85 or I don't know 90 can clear in older. So yeah, pretty easy. Even if you're not gonna buy the logout, but really I suggest it, because who wants to clear these old raids just to get a raid ID going? But yeah, you enter it and you don't have to worry about, you know, heroic or normal, whatever. Just gonna accept it. And obviously the only boss that is alive now is Juxeran. And I never quite understood the whole hard mode and whatnot. I just assume that if you clear it and you put it on heroic and it's 25 man heroic, you do it correctly and you set it up to be zero keepers or whatever it's called. But yeah, in order to speed this fight up, you're obviously gonna run into the clouds. That is the old ancient tactics for soloing this fight faster. Anywho, I also want to talk a little about efficiency. You should definitely keep raid logouts on a character that you don't like to solo on. So in my case, that is a mage. I really despise my mage. Okay, shouldn't be swearing, but damn do I hate the mage. I have no idea why anyone would want to play a mage anymore in this time and day. I don't know if it's just the other characters that I do have a level 100 that are much better. But the mage character just seems to suck ass completely. Like, yeah, I mean, even with heroism and other really good cooldowns, it's still really slow to solo on. And without the Kazakh leech trinket on or some other form of leech, I die way too easily. But yeah, that is why I keep all the logouts on this character and not, say, my paladin who's retribution. But yeah, now we're just waiting for the brain portal, and I like to just, you know, bother killing the tentacles that do spawn while waiting. It doesn't really matter, I suppose, but gotta do something. Maybe I should alt-tab out and watch some YouTube. But yeah, so it's nice to have deadly boss modes for this specific fight here if you don't have such an add-on. So you can see when the portal do spawn and be ready for it. And always when the portal spawn, you're gonna get, you know, clawed again from a tentacle. Just kill it real fast with a general AoE spell. And then you're just gonna clear the brain room. Now the really good part here is that you need to not even use cooldowns to get the brain down. So yeah, just do whatever. And then you're just gonna be instant knocked out, and then you can pop all your cooldowns you want to for the last phase. And now I'll show the loot just to really, you know, do show that I actually was on hard mode and all that good stuff. So as you can see here, Dark Age Depraver Team, that is the hard mode loot, so it worked and everything was correct. But yeah. This was pretty much it for the guide. I hope you found it useful. It's a bit complicated to do this, but I wanted to include four different, you know, logouts. Some of them are harder than others. Some of them are maybe even borderline exploit. But I wanted to make a compilation video now where I just get it all together, and I hope you can use this. So yeah. have a good one and goodbye.